Hello, welcome to the ReadyTech Skills and Fundamentals. We are discussing how to select a topic of the research for the PG and PhD students of Electrical Engineering. Up to now, we have discussed the three videos, how to select industries, how to select an area, and how to select an application. So, today we are going to discuss about selecting the topic and how topic is different than the selecting the title. Up to now, you might selected your area or application to start your research career in the field of electrical engineering. So today we are going to discuss about what is the topic and how to select the topic of your research. So, the topic is basically a subject on which you are going to do the research. So, you will do the research on your topic, you will collect the information about your topic. The topic is the subject on which you will find the gaps, you will find the issues, and you will find the problems to finalize your title. So, after doing research on the topic, you will find the or you will finally select the title. So title is the name of your thesis, right? And title is very specific. But topic is a subject. You might already know more about your subject, or you will do the in-depth research in the particular subject. So this is your topic. Let's say, for example, your topic might be speech latex motor, your topic might be BLDC, your topic might be transient analysis, your topic might be multi-level inverter, your topic might be power system, stability and control. So this way you will select the topic. But how to select the good topic? So your topic should be latest and futuristic. So why we select the topic latest and futuristic? Latest means it should be in current trend. And futuristic, that means it might be possible that currently this topic is not have the industrial acceptance, but in future likely it is possible that you can predict what will be what type of problem will arise in future and how we can solve and how we can work on the future topic. So it might be futuristic. And additional benefit you will get from your futuristic and latest topic is that when you publish the paper related to the topic, you will have the more chances of acceptance because the journal are ranked based on their impact factor. And what is this impact factor? It is nothing but how many readers are there to read and cite this paper. So if more readers are willing to read this type of topic, this type of publication, then they will read, and then if they will read, then definitely they will cite your paper in their publication. So more citation will increase the impact factor of journal. So this is also one benefit of having latest and futuristic topic. Now next question comes in mind, that is how to select the topic. So as we already discussed about selecting the area or application, so there is the two types of people. One, those already finalized their area and application and topic, then they will search for the problem for their topic. Or if you go through the process that explaining the previous video of the application, you are reading the different magazine, you come to a real life problem. And likewise, if you finalize your application and the particular problem, then from the problem also you can find out the topic. So if you want to work in this particular application, and then you can find the problem to select the topic. So either you select your problem from your topic, or you select your topic from your selected problem or application. Now after selecting the topic, let's discuss how to analyze and validate your topic for either it is latest or realistic or futuristic or not. So to do so, what you need to do, go to the IEEE Explore site, then search for your topic, enter your topic, and note down the number of publication year by year for your topics. So you can have the different filters over there. You know how to search for year wise for your topic. So when you search for your topic, you will find number of papers available on your topic, and by analyzing this way, note down the number of paper year by year, and you can see the growth of publishing growth of your paper. So how people are publishing on your particular topic, that is also important. Look at the year. One example of the switch reluctance motor. So how the publications for the switch reluctance motors are going increasing exponentially year by year, which shows there is the continuous growth and future demand also for this particular topic. So if you finalize the topic, then do the little bit work to have the data on number of publication and plot the graph. It will also help you in your research proposal to validate your topic, that your topic is latest and also have the demand from the readers and from the industries also. So this way you can analyze and validate your topic also. So in next video we will discuss about the finalizing title.